What's up, YouTube? Today we're going to do a teardown and repair video for the Nexus 5X. This phone is made by LG. First thing you want to do is remove the SIM card tray. Take a little tool, put it in the hole, and the SIM card tray will pop out and you can remove it from your device. Then the back plastic of the phone will unsnap from the screen. It is held on pretty tight, so if you make a little opening with your fingernail, you can put a pry tool in between the screen and the back frame, and you can unpop each of the little latches from the frame and remove the back. There is no adhesive, which is very nice. Just slide your pry tool all along the edge and all of the little clasps will come undone. We can see that we'll need a screwdriver to remove the back plastics from the phone. I will link all the tools down in the video description. To remove the lower plastic bracket, there's four screws, and then pop it off the base of the phone with a pry tool and remove it. This is actually the loudspeaker of the phone. You can see the two contact points down here at the bottom. I will link replacement parts in the video description below as well. There are six screws along the top. I used a razor blade to start the top corner. I just lift it up a little bit and then I can unsnap the rest of the back plastic piece off of the phone. Here's the battery connection. Just unsnap that like a little Lego. Same thing with the rear camera and the front facing camera. And then we have the LCD connection down here at the bottom. Unsnap all of those and then the motherboard can be released from the phone body. Here we see the LEDs for the camera as well as some noise canceling microphones and the charging port down here at the bottom. Unfortunately, is not replaceable. It is soldered onto the board. So if your charging port ever goes back, you're just out of luck unless you can solder. Here's a SIM card tray at the back as well. This is not replaceable either. The battery is held in with adhesive. If you're going to pry it out, it is helpful if you have a sturdy metal pry tool. The thing you want to be really careful of though is to make sure not to puncture the battery at all. That will ruin the battery. Once it's lifted up just a little bit, switch to a plastic tool because you are less likely to rip anything on the battery itself. Here's the battery. I will link replacement batteries down in the video description. Usually they're pretty darn cheap. Here's the rear facing camera. This is a 12.3 megapixel camera, and if you think that's a weird number, it's because it is. Here is the front-facing camera. It is a 5 megapixel. Pretty cute little guy. Here's the vibrator motor. You can see the two gold little springs that are up at the top, and those rest in contact with the main board, and that's how it receives its signal. Here's the earpiece. It's got some metallic tape along the top. Take that off and put it somewhere safe. You're going to reuse it. If you have to replace your earpiece, you want to put the tape back down on top of it again. Pretty straightforward. Has the two gold contact points as well that just rest against the motherboard. Here is the headphone jack. Has the same kind of gold pins along the side that communicate with the motherboard as well. Here's the screen. It is an IPS LCD display, similar to what the iPhones have. If you're going to replace your screen, there's a good chance that when you buy it, it will not come with the plastic frame. So you have to remove the screen, which is the LCD in the glass, from the plastic frame. If your LCD is already broken, this won't be a big deal. Just heat it up and pull it out from the device. I'm not going to do it in this video just because the chances of my screen surviving the removal from the back frame is pretty slim. If you can find a screen that is sold with the frame intact, so the LCD, the glass panel in the front, and the back plastic frame, that would be ideal. And in the past, LG has sold them as whole units, so hopefully they continue to do that in the future. I'm going to go ahead and snap all the pieces back into the phone again. The front-facing camera, the vibrator motor, and then here is the earpiece. Going to use that same metal tape to tack it back down into place. Here's the rear camera, 12.3 megapixels, and the headphone jack. Just going to pop that back into a little holder that is there on the plastic frame, and then the motherboard goes down into place as well. Make sure the little ribbon cables for all the parts are on the upper side of the motherboard, and then snap those down into place like little Lego pieces, and then make sure the motherboard is pressed down along that headphone jack as well so that the gold contact points will touch the motherboard and receive their communication. Put the battery back into place, clip it onto the main board, and then here's something kind of cool. So there's a bunch of pins on the motherboard, and those come in contact with this back plastic piece, and that is how the fingerprint scanner receives its communication from the main board as well. There's a couple water damage indicators, one there on the back of the phone, and then one more, if you saw previously in the video, in the SIM card tray slot. So those will tell if your phone has been wet or not. Go ahead and put that loudspeaker back into place, and then put all screws in as well. Remember, all the tools and stuff are down in the video description. And then the back plastic piece will just clamp down into place. It is very, very secure. That back plastic panel does not want to come off easy, so you have to use a little bit of pressure to snap it down into place. If you have any questions, go ahead and leave them in the comments below. Don't forget to like if this video helped you or you found it interesting. And don't forget to subscribe. Thanks a ton for watching. Hope to see you around. Feel free to scroll through my channel and check out some of my other repair videos or durability test videos.